en alles is well, focused on interaction. So and in terms of task analysis, you would say whenever agents are interacting with each other or with technology or through technology or exchanging objects, physical or non-physical objects, something happens. This is the moment that it happens. So Bridget Jordan labels this hotspots. Hotspots are situations where it happens, where something special happens, right? And so try to find out. And sometimes they are in documents, sometimes people tell you stories, and sometimes you just happen to perceive. You are at the right time, at the right spot, and say, wow, this is unexpected. Right? So, and collect registrations, and if you have enough time, you have not this week, but Bridget Jordan had for in her air traffic control. She was 6 months in the air traffic suites, so she could record multiple instances of the same thing. So some things happen, and after 2 weeks it happens again, and trying to collect several of them, and then describe them in detail. So a content log, meaning you describe the participants, the situation, the artifacts or the objects, anything. And you try to describe every type of communication. So verbal communication, body language, movements, ways people behave. So somebody could at a certain moment go and sit somewhere else, right? So this could have a meaning. To describe everything that happens. And what real ethnographers do in companies like the analysis of air traffic control and at Xerox, they have been doing a lot of ethnography, and long ago they actually also did at Apple Advanced Technology. The ethnographers will meet and they will have review sessions. Sometimes they collect comments from the people that are members of the community of practice. They ask, could you explain what happens here? You ask people to think aloud, to identify things, and then in the end they propose what they call hypotheses. A hypothesis in terms of ethnography means a first idea of a pattern, of something that seems to be a regularity or seems to have a meaning. And then you have to find out, is this just something funny that happens, or is this kind of normal or self kind of standard thing, right? And so one thing that ethnographers sometimes use is a surprise index. Where a surprise index is not something with a number. It's an index, but it's not a surprise index is 5 or 6. A surprise index means that as an ethnographer you should try to understand as much as the people in the community of practice. You shouldn't try to understand more, and you are not done yet if you understand less. So try to be as surprised as the people who belong to the situation, to the context, right? And if people in the context at a certain moment say, wow, this is new, then it's good if you also say, wow, this is new. And don't try to say, but I should understand. No, an ethnographer should not understand more than the people in the community of practice. So the surprise index in a way tells you, now you can stop, because now you are a part of us, right? And then there is a lot of attention for a systematic coverage. An ethnographer, at least for if you would like to do task analysis, would like to make sure that you, for instance, cover all the space. So if I'm here in this USI compartments, then I already found out there's lecture halls, lecture rooms, there's a coffee room, there's rooms where people are working or chatting or having lunch. And so what's going on between you or between you and us is not just here, it's also in the corridor, it's also with the coffee, right? It might even be downstairs waiting for the elevator. So try to cover everything or you will miss important things. Because sometimes people make a decision or ask questions when they are walking to the car in the parking lot to each other, right? And this is part of the coverage. So cover the complete space. Also cover the complete time. So not only what happens in working hours, but maybe in between if there's a break, or after hours if people call each other, or if on Saturday people come together to do some sports. And look at what are all the actors that are participating. And this could not only be the people that are employed by the company. It could be there are other people that are also related. So if you have a shop in a shopping mall or a shopping street, it might well be that if you be an ethnographer and hang around in the shop, you find out that the shopkeeper of the shop next door every morning at 9:15 comes, enters the shop and has a coffee with the shop owner and talks a little bit about the business yesterday, right? And so this person is part of the community of practice and could influence and is of significance, even if he's not employed by this shop, but it's just a neighbor. But if the neighbor always comes to discuss stuff, well, you should cover that. So make sure that you get, so like this would be an unofficial consultant, right? But just ask for people that are on the paying list. And this is an interesting one that we might need. You cannot look at everything at any place and at all time, right? So you have to make choices. And ethnographers normally make choices based on what they find out during the first phase. If they hang around, they find out that certain things could be important. So, and then they call, they speak about orientation, which is systematic viewpoints. And in a way there are four, that you could orient on persons, on objects, on settings, or on tasks. So let me cover them briefly, all four of them. So a person-oriented record means that you are at a certain moment convinced that things happen during, let me say, a day in the life of some of the key actors, the key agents, right? So what you do then in that case is try to be allowed to walk with one or more of the key agents for a full day or for a full shift or actually maybe for a full week. Right, so stay with the people and see what happens when they start their work until they stop with it and maybe for a couple of days. So this we call this a person-oriented record and a good example is a day in the life of. Right? So if it makes sense to design to develop personas for certain agents, then it might also make sense as an ethnographer to develop a record of a day in the life of. Right?